Welcome, everyone. Welcome to Crashes and Taxes. I am your host, of course, Rebecca Walser, and we are so excited today because we have a special guest, Daniel Alonzo, and he is a multimillionaire from a young age, been doing this for a long, long time, saw the light, realized, man, I don't want to just get a, you know, corporate job and work the corporate rat race for the rest of my life. He decided, let me go out and really some personal circumstances that we're going to let him share with us that said, hey, I got to figure this out at a young age, 21. He said, I've got to figure this out and do something differently. And so we're really excited to have you with us today, Daniel. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks, Rebecca. I'm so happy to have to be on with you today.
Yeah, and we're doing this as a video podcast, but of course, a lot of you are listening via sound. But it's too bad that if you can't see the video, that you can't see Daniel, because he is in front of beautiful California palm trees, and you know, it makes me jealous. And I'm in Florida. I've got some great palm trees of my own, but his lifestyle is looking really making me jealous right now. Dan, before you know, I don't want to take up too much time. I want to give you all the time. So please start. You had such a unique experience at such a young age that made you sort of say, "Wow, I don't want to do this." Standard American college and graduation and all of those things the normal way. I know that you had some professional sports aspirations and that. So tell us about that. Take us back to those days and how did you get started on this really amazing path?
Well, I really wasn't a good student growing up. You know, I always thought of myself as, I mean, I was a slow reader. I couldn't get things that well. I mean, I just had difficulty, you know, just in the educational system, the traditional educational system. Mm-hmm. I just didn't enjoy it. And mm-hmm. I feel like, and I felt like I had to do something different. And you know, so I got it, you know, college, I ended up going to college. I started playing baseball. I played baseball all my life and hurt my knee real bad. And my mm-hmm. college aspirations, even though I was trying, but the only reason why I was going to college is because the only reason why I was going to college is because I wanted to play baseball.
Right.
But I hated going to college. I hated the learning, bro. I hated going to class, you know.
Right.
I was one of those kids, right? And I hurt my knee real bad and my baseball career was over and I came back home and I just felt like a loser, Rebecca.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I was, you know, hanging out with the wrong crowd, partying way too much, just doing all the bad things that you could imagine doing.
Yeah.
And a buddy of mine said, hey, man, you need to check out this financial services business. And the rest is history. From there, I went for it.
Wow. So what age were you when you decided, all right, I'm going to go check out this financial services business? Just to get around like 21, 22-ish, 21?
21, yep. It was 21 years old. And
wow.
I mean, everybody told me I was crazy. I totally quit college. I was like,
wow.
I ain't never going back there no more. I was like, I saw the light. But it reminds you that some of the most successful people in the world, the reason why they became successful is because they went all in. They went for it. You know, and so many people, they play around everything. They play around way too much. And I just said, I'm going for it. And I think that's what helped me so much in the beginning.
So how did you, at that age, with no official degree, actually get anybody to sit down and talk to you and listen to you? I mean, what was that learning process like? I mean, you were probably drinking from a fire hose to learn all about financial services at that age. And I'm sure you were hungry and motivated.
Yeah.
Like you were very motivated. So how did that go? How did you start seeing people and actually starting to build this business that you've built now?
So it was harder than hell in the beginning because I had no credibility.
No, everyone, he said it is harder than hell. He said that. So nothing that is worth getting is easy. That is a myth. That is a lie. Do not believe anybody that tells you this is easy. You can replicate my system in 5 days. No.
Oh my God.
Hard work. Sorry.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
I'm totally with you, Rebecca, because I hate people when they say get rich quick scheme and all this. It's all effing bullshit.
Right.
And I just so it was harder than hell. I mean, because I had no credibility. Nobody wanted to listen to me. So what I did, though, that really helped me a lot is I studied great salespeople.
Wow.
I studied great influencers, Tom Hopkins, maybe you might have heard of him before,
mm-hmm.
Anthony Robbins. I also attracted a really smart guy and really successful guy in my business. And I said, you're going to be my mentor.
Wow.
And I attached my little red wagon with his. And I said, just tell me what I need to do. I'm willing to roll up my sleeves, get dirty. I'm willing to work, get up earlier and stay up later. Just tell me what I got to do. And that's what it was. So because I knew how to get people to say yes.
Okay.
And I also studied the business. Like I made sure that my products were good. I made sure that they were good for people.
Right.
And so it allowed me to be able to really get behind what I was selling. I believed in my product. I believed in what I was doing. And so the next thing you know, people started saying yes.
Yes.
But then Rebecca.
Interject for our podcast. Okay. He said he had the hunger and the drive to get up early and to stay late. It comes within you. Nobody can teach it. It's something that comes within you. If you are a natural born entrepreneur, you are going to feel that hunger and that drive that Dan just described. And if you don't, maybe a corporate job is the right fit for you. But if you have what he has, which is his innate, not something that can be created, not something that can be forced, not something that can be taught even, he figured out on his own. He went out and self-studied, found the gurus of sales, studied his products, learned his business, and then he started getting yeses. So that's the secret sauce right there. There's no other secret to the secret sauce. That's it. Sorry, Dan, please go ahead.
No, seriously. I mean, and then what I started to do is I started to recruit and then train and duplicate and think distribution. I was, every day I got up, I was thinking, I got to get people licensed. I got to get people competent. I trained people. I developed people. Every time I would get a result, I'd call my top 20% or guys on my team. And I would teach them like, this is what I said. This is the overcoming objections this is the objection that I got. And this is how I overcame it.
So let me get this straight, Dan. Are you saying that you started recruiting people right away, right out of the gate? You started getting people to work alongside you and with you as early as right that. Wow, that's incredible. Incredible.
Yeah,
wow.
I started to recruit people because I was thinking, you know, I love to sell. I love to market my products. I love all that stuff. I just didn't want to have to do it till I'm 80.
Right.
Right. I mean, I've seen some of these guys in financial services. They're 80 years old. They're still with their little briefcase, you know, walking down the street, going door to door and all that crap. And right. I never went door to door and I never cold called. I never advertised, never spent one dime in advertising. And it was really just word of mouth. What I was doing is I was building my business through best friends of best friends of best friends, referrals, group presentations, churches, you know, police departments, fire departments, businesses, all these different, you know, places where I can meet people, schools. And I started to build out my brand from there. People started referring people to me.
That's amazing. So in your story, you talk about a special milestone that you hit at 28. After you got married to your high school sweetheart, young age, and then you hit a special milestone. At 28, you knew that you were going to be successful. Can you share that with us?
Well, I mean, you know, we preach as a company, we preach to live below your means, save your money, right? Don't go buy stupid shit, you know? And so what I was trying to go for was financial independence, not I want to look good so you could think I'm cool, right? Or I'm rich or whatever, right? I didn't
get it. Not the faith that you make it. You were living modestly. You were living a modest lifestyle and really, really banking the dollars. Okay.
Totally. Wow. And so because I learned financial services, I knew how to invest my money. Because I had the financial education. I understood the rule of 72. I understood a compound interest. I understood that that if I take advantage of those type of investments, I could grow my money a lot quicker. So there was years. I mean, I'm not kidding. There was years that I was saving 60% of my income. Okay.
Wow.
I was saving 60%. I was living on nothing. I was making $300,000, $350,000, and I was driving a $10,000 Maxima.
Oh, wow.
And
that's amazing.
I was living in a 1,200 square foot condo. All right. That we paid $114,000 for. Wow. And my mortgage payment was like $500 or something like that. And I just, so because I wanted to be done by the time I was 30,
okay.
I said, I don't care what
like
anybody says about me. Yeah, I just, that was my focus, you know, so there was years in there where I was making 100% rate of return on my money. Because I mean, especially that was back in the 99 and 2000, sure. 2000, you know, like
tech
in those
boom.
Areas.
Tech boom.
Tech boom. I had some, you know, aggressive portfolios that I was dumping large amounts of money into.
Nice.
The company stock actually was doing fantastic at the time. And then I, you know, I studied a lot. So I knew kind of when to make some moves, you know,
right.
at certain times and make my money grow a little bit faster. And so I woke up and I was 28 years old. Not only did I save $1 million, but I also had passive income coming in of about $500,000 a year. And
wow.
That was like when I kind of went, all right, by 28 years old. And that's when I said, you know what, I'm good. I went and talked to a couple of my top guys and I'm like, hey man, take it, go. I semi-retired for just call it 10 years, easy 10, 12 years. I semi-retired.
Enjoyed yourself? Did you spend a little bit more money then? No.
I did. I bought a nicer home.
Nice.
But even at that point, I had a home that was, I mean, I think we sold it for maybe, you know, $800,000 or something like that. But it was completely paid off. We paid off our house. We were completely financed. I do not have debt. I have never... All right, this is God honest truth. I have never paid a finance charge on a credit card before. Credit card companies hate me, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Always paid it off, automatic draft. I've you know, had my systems in place. I use my Quicken to this day. You know, I know it's a simple little thing. I don't have inventory and overhead and things like that,
right.
But I have just a simple little business account, and I'm very, very organized. Even to this day, we live in obviously a much bigger, nicer house today, and I drive nicer cars today. But the truth is my life is pretty simple. I mm-hmm. like the fact that tomorrow, if I want to go take a trip across the country and nobody sees me for 6 months, my income will continue on and
wow.
I can do whatever I want to do whenever I want to do it. And now
yeah.
because of Zoom, shoot, I could transact business all over the world now. So the ability to travel and work and connect with people has never been more exciting and fun than it is right now.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So you just touched on a couple of key points. You basically became a millionaire at 28. You lived below your means. You had amazing self-discipline. You built out a team that did the work for you so that you could passively take off for 6 months, which I'm sure you never have, but you could if you wanted to. And now you're living a little bit higher of a lifestyle, but you're still probably living, I'm sure, below your means. And you have a team that's doing this for you. So you really scaled and you really had other people doing the work for you. That is so unique. I love, in this world, you get a lot of these real estate professionals that come and say, oh, you know, build a real estate portfolio. And I'm like, okay, but who's doing the work for you? Because people get sick of a property manager, you know, taking, I had one recently come to me and they said, well, they started out 7, then 8, then 10, now 15%. And, you know, they're so ingrained into their business that they can't really kind of cut them out, extract them, start over with somebody else. So do you have any like words of advice for people that are listening that are thinking, I want to follow? I know you have an Alonzo Academy, which is a kind of a coaching. Is that for more people that are in the financial services space, Dan, or where does that work in your practice?
Well, it's actually called Wealth on the Beach Club. Alonzo
Wealth
Academy is my website, alonzoacademy.com. And you can kind of get all the little things
yeah.
that I do and the connect sheet of my YouTube channel and all that good stuff. But,
yeah.
But really, the Wealth on the Beach Club is mainly for people in financial services, although I have had people join just because they want to learn duplication, they want to learn distribution,
mm-hmm.
they're interested in scaling their businesses. And
yeah.
so, of course, I've helped people like that too. But since it's 99% people in financial services, we mainly talk about leadership, distribution, coaching. We talk about, of course, financial services, how to
sure.
get more people to say yes to you
yeah.
and how to be a person of influence and build a brand.
That's amazing. That is so phenomenal. Your story strikes me as, even though it's a very specific to, you know, our world of financial services, it's the story of America. It's the story of entrepreneurship. It's the story of individualism and saying, hey, I'm going to build and create my own life and my own path and my own way. And you have the drive. And I think so many people want the get rich quick scheme. They want to go to a weekend seminar that they got a flyer in the mail on that says, you know, come to our seminar and you can be flipping 50 properties in 2 months and without using your own money. You've seen those things, Dan. This stuff is crazy. And then you can't teach. I get a lot of people that contact me and say, oh, Rebecca, how did you get this? How did you achieve that? It's freaking hard work, you know, and nobody says that at the top. Nobody would turn around and say, how did I get here? Through hard work. I mean, obviously we all get breaks. We all have some kind of lucky. You met the guy who turned you on to the company and that changed your life, you know, but it changed your life because you took the opportunity and you made it happen. And so obviously we all get breaks and we all get blessings, but still, I just think, is there anything that more that we can glean from you in this quick, short podcast that users can say, hey, this guy did on his own? I mean, any advice from the financial services world about the market, potentially where it's going with the virus, and what do you think, and how are you reacting to people being sort of insecure right now about what's going on with the U.S.?
Well, the first thing, I just want to step back real quick and just say that I didn't do it by myself. Yes. I'm not I literally have an amazing team. We have 47 locations today. We have 1,500 licensed agents in financial services. And so I'm very proud of them. I'm very proud of the team that we have today. I am a very, very small piece of what makes it great today, because we have so many amazing leaders and so many people. I mean, we have some leaders that run locations, they make 100,000, some make 200, some make 300, some make a half a million. Some, you know, I have a lady that makes $1 million a year in passive income for so many years that we trained and taught and mentored through the years. And so it's just exciting to know that there is a way for people to transform their lives, if they're willing to transform themselves personally, if they're willing to put in the hard work, the effort. And so I just wanted to say that because, those people are extremely important to me. And I'm extremely grateful, Rebecca, to the fact that I was allowed, because we live in America, to have the freedom to make my own choices, to build my own business. With you know, yes, there's regulation, but with less regulation, and to allow me to continue on. Now, as far as the market, look, the market is, in my opinion, has a rude awakening next year. Okay, that's what I'm forecasting, at least. And I've taken many, many classes, and I have a lot of really, really smart mentors in the business. And I think that because we really never went through that major downturn. Now we took a 30% hit, but you know, obviously that's all been recovered completely. Yep, but it was a very short period of time. And I don't even know if we really are in a recession, because everybody says we're in a recession, but the truth is there's so much fake money out there. There's so much printing of money right now. It's ridiculous. So eventually that's going to have to stop. Otherwise we're going to devalue the dollar and we'll never get out of this thing alive. We'll all, it'll be Zimbabwe America, right? And so we don't want that. It's going to have to stop. People are going to stop getting checks. They're going to stop getting for free. And then if we're not careful about the political arena, it's going to come November. If we don't get the right person in office, Rebecca, we are number one, going to all be wearing masks for the rest of our lives. Absolutely. And they're going to tank the market through socialism. That's what is really, so again, right person gets in, maybe we might be okay, but the wrong person gets in, it's going to be very, very scary, Rebecca. And I think that we're going to take a major, because again, we really have not had that major downturn in the market for a long, you know, usually downturns usually go for, you know, 2 or 3 years in most cases. And so historically, and so we just haven't gone through that yet. It's coming. So people better get prepared.
So basically the CARES Act stimulus hopped us over the natural down cycle that would happen when you have 42 million people go on unemployment. And you see this election, it sounds like the way I see it, which is an election between capitalism and socialism, and going towards more government ownership, and government takeovers than the America that we've built that allowed you to establish your business and become so successful that allowed me to establish my business. It is a huge election. I think that this is, I know people say it every time it happens, but honestly, this is the starkest election in my lifetime that I've ever seen. And I know a lot of people feel that way. So I hope everyone gets out to the polls and votes for freedom. That's all I can say about that. Because without freedom, we're not America. Please. We might as well just go live somewhere else. You know, it's not America without freedom. And that's freedom for everybody. We want freedom for everybody at everybody. We don't need to impose anything on anybody. Let's just be free and let's all live. But Dan, thank you so, so much for joining us on Crashes and Taxes. This was phenomenal. Where can people get more information about you if they are interested in your coaching, your Wealth on the Beach coaching? Where can they go?
So, of course, go to alonzoacademy.com. That'll give you access to everything. I have a YouTube channel that's really good. I have, of course, I'm on Twitter and Instagram. Instagram, if anybody wants to ever send me a message or say they have a question for me, go to Instagram at Daniel Alonzo. It's with a Z-O at the end. Mm-hmm. And then just leave me a message. I answer all of my DMs, and it's me personally. It's not my assistant.
Shocking. That's amazing. I don't even do that.
It's me personally that answers every DM. I am so engaged in my social media right now. Look, the truth is, Rebecca, I am blessed and grateful for everything I have. And the truth is, I want to give back. I want to help people. I want to make a difference in people's lives. And I am dedicated to making that a reality. And so I'm not stopping.
Awesome. You've been awesome. I'm so sorry that our podcast is so short. We could have talked to you for an hour. But thank you so much, Daniel, for joining us. Daniel Alonzo, alonzoacademy.com, and Daniel Alonzo, Z-O, on Instagram, Twitter, all the other places you can find him. Thank you again. We appreciate it. We absolutely appreciate it. We wish you all the blessings for your practice. And we just thank you for joining us on this episode of Crashes and Taxes. Until next time, everybody, have a great day.